say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming? And the rocket red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star spangled
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the legal services performed by other lawyers. Many of you have now heard the term stepped-up basis and it possibly being eliminated, which is very concerning. I encourage you to schedule your free 15-minute consultation with attorney Harlan Mitchell to find out what you can do to protect yourself and your family. Schedule your appointment with attorney Harlan Mitchell by calling 256-216-9884. Or by going to BamaEstatePlanning.com. Do it today. Boutique Air in Muscle Shoals, Alabama offers direct flights to Atlanta, Nashville, and Pensacola. Boutique Air service runs twice daily, 7 days a week, with fares starting at $59. Follow Boutique Air Muscle Shoals on Facebook at Boutique Air MSL and book your flight through BoutiqueAir.com. Boutique Air.
Where you can fly private for the cost of commercial.
You've heard me talk about telemedicine at Trinity Medical Care Center here on The Mark White Show. With Trinity Medical Care Center's telemedicine, you can skip the commute and get the care you need from the safety and comfort of your own home. You can contact Trinity Medical Care Center by calling 256-489-3192. You can also schedule an appointment on the web by going to trinity-medicalcare.com. Again, give them a call at 256-489-3192 and give telemedicine a try today.
Experience the difference at Athens Bible School. The vision and purpose is to provide each student a quality education in a Christ-centered environment to develop the whole person spiritually, mentally, physically, and socially in safe and supportive surroundings. The solid biblical foundation permeates learning and culture in the classrooms and every extracurricular activity.
You know, my mother used to say, long time ago, whenever there would be any real catastrophe that was in the movies or on the air, she would say, always look for the helpers. There will always be helpers, just on the sidelines. That's why I think that if news programs could make a conscious effort of showing anybody who is coming into a place where there's a tragedy, to be sure that they include that. Because if you look for the helpers, you'll know that there's hope.
Hey everybody, this is Daryl Worley, and you're listening to The Mark White Show. Hey, step up and make a difference like he does.
Hey y'all, this is Jeff Foxworthy, and you, yeah, you can make a huge difference in somebody's life. You just may not have figured out how yet, and that's why you're listening to The Mark White Show.
Hi, this is Maggie Peterson. I played Charlene Darling on The Andy Griffith Show, and you are listening to The Mark White Show.
Hi, folks. This is Ricky Skaggs, and you're listening to The Mark White Show.
Hello, I'm Gene Stallings, and this is The Mark White Show. Get off the sideline and get involved and make a difference in your community.
You are listening to The Mark White Show. My daddy is your host, Mark White.
Do something good today.
On January 25th, which was Monday, a tornado went through Fultondale, Center Point, Tarrant area. I grew up in the Center Point area early on, went to Irwin to high school, Arthur Elementary School, Birmingham City School there, and tragedy struck the Fultondale area. We lost a young man in the tornado, Elliott Arizaga-Hernandez, and his family's grieving right now, and I wanted to find a way to help move an effort forward that one of his teachers, Jason Vogt, has organized to help the family. This is a very difficult time for this family. Absolutely heartbreaking that we have lost this young man, but I did want to point out this fundraiser and how you can help make a difference during this time for the Arizaga-Hernandez family. Welcome to the Mark White Show, Jason Vogt.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
I appreciate the fact that you care enough about this student and his family to organize a fundraiser to help them, and how important it is right now that the community rally around this family and their loss. Yes, we had damage to buildings. Those things can be replaced. People can't.
Yeah, I completely agree. You know, when I first heard about the tornado, I immediately got up in that area and was trying to help. Then shortly thereafter, our principal released the information that Elliott had passed away. And I honestly, my heart just broke in that moment. The grief of losing a child is so great. And I have two children of my own, and I just can't imagine. I couldn't imagine what their family was going through.
As a teacher at Fultondale Middle and High School, you had a unique opportunity to get to know Elliott and the type of person he was. You described him as a sweet and kind student. And I know that when a teacher says that, the student must really be sweet and kind.
Yeah, you know, you get an opportunity to meet a kid and you can really see their true colors and see what kind of person they are over time. And that statement was 100% true.
How long have you been a teacher, Jason?
So I'm going to my 14th year of teaching. It's my second year in Jefferson County, fifth year in Alabama.
It's already been hard enough through 2020 with COVID and students having to deal with that situation along with teachers and parents. And here now in 2021, we have similar issues going on with virtual school, hybrid school, the different situations. And there is a disconnect, I would say, at times between the parents and teachers and students with how things are going. But this can definitely reconnect people and allow them to be one on a singular mission to try to help the Arizaga-Hernandez family.
Yes, I completely agree. I have been in contact with most of my first period students, the class that Elliott was in, and I'm amazed at how many parents have already heard of this movement to help Elliott's family. Parents are thanking me, but it's 100% right. The community is uniting. People are sharing this movement and this GoFundMe page across their social media platforms, and big numbers are being raised through our platform. And I'm so thankful that the community is taking this and running with it.
Well, I know one of the things that you said in your post in the GoFundMe was that you wanted to help raise as much money as possible to help support this family. And as you know, money doesn't replace Elliott, but at the same time, there are expenses that are there. The family needs to not have to worry about money during this time. Financial burdens should not be what they're concerned with.
Yeah. You know, right now I don't even have a goal. When I set this up, I just thought, let's get as much money as we can. And the people keep amazing me. I keep on adjusting the goal on the GoFundMe page. And I was speaking to my wife this morning and I said, Aaron, do you think we're going to get $50,000? And she said, Jason, it's possible. So I'm praying that, you know, people will continue to show up and that number just continues to grow. And like you said, the money is never going to replace Elliott, not one bit. I've been speaking to his family and his brothers. It's not going to replace him. It's not going to change the hurt and the pain and the sorrow. But if we can do something as a community to help them not have to worry about bills and expenses, about hospital bills, rebuilding a home, those kind of things, then I think we've done a great job as a community.
What made you think about setting up the GoFundMe and getting this ball rolling, Jason?
I'm going to be honest with you. I don't even know. I just knew I had to do something. I couldn't sit still. I'm the kind of teacher that cares too much sometimes. I've been called the Care Bear before. And my words, I say a lot of words. I constantly tell the kids I care about them. I love you. You know, what can I do for you? What can I do to help? And after a day of thinking about it, what I could do to help, I finally thought that it was time for me to put my words into action. And I thought that this was one of the best ways I could do it. You know, I spoke with our principal and I spoke to the district and I spoke with their family and I got the go ahead from all three and I ran with it. And, like I said, I'm just amazed. I honestly, Mr. White, I thought that $1,000 was great. I thought $1,000 was great. And here we are sitting at over 20,000. And who knows what God has in store for us and what this number is going to get to, but I'm working hard. I'm pushing. I'm trying super hard to make this not just a Alabama thing, but a nationwide thing. I want people to know about Elliott. I want people to know that he was a great person and that his family needs help.
Of course, we're just a few days removed from when the tornado hit in the Fultondale area. How has this made the family feel? You mentioned that you had interacted with them about this fundraiser. How has this helped them emotionally so far?
I think they're just in amazement, just like me. They're thankful. I just spoke with a brother a little bit ago, and he asked me to post an announcement on the page that he's just so appreciative to everybody. We've got over 400 donors already. And I've been trying to say thank you to each one of them for that family, but his family is just Elliott's family, his brothers, is I'm sure his parents, I haven't spoken to his parents, but his brothers are just amazed and, they're thankful. Very thankful.
I'm looking right here. The most recent donation comes from Rogersville, Alabama to the tune of $500. And it comes from a congregation, a church there in Rogersville, Alabama, where I actually went to high school myself at Lauderdale County High School. So it is reaching farther outside of Fultondale and, of course, people across the country. It's almost been shared 1,000 times. And as you said, over 400 donors so far. And this can really be impactful for this family at $21,405 so far. And I don't see any end to it because people want to find a way to help. When these things happen, the thing about it is you're on the outside looking in. You know that first responders, you know that utility workers and other service personnel, volunteers are out there working. And then you're at home wondering, what can I do? And then you see a group at Waffle House serving up food for people who are volunteers out there and trying to help. You see people who are stepping in to find those opportunities, and maybe you're still at home. But this gives you an opportunity to reach out and to find a way to actually help this community.
I did want to let you know, I also have another effort that I've created here in my neighborhood. I live in Crestwood, and I created what's called the Friends of Fultondale.
Okay.
And it's an opportunity. It's an opportunity for people within my neighborhood that are neighbors of Fultondale to donate and gather supplies and money for the tornado relief program as well. And so that's located out of Crestwood Pharmacy. Taylor, the owner, is helping me organize that. And we're already seeing good things from that, too. I didn't create a GoFundMe. It's just an opportunity for people to drop things off. My church, Mountaintop Community Church, is also a drop-off location. They're promoting it for me, too, pushing it out there. But I've been pushing it on all social media platforms. We're already seeing lots of donations come in. I just can't say thank you enough to the people that have already answered the call, and to those that will moving forward to support this family. And, you know, that Rogersville family, that Rogersville congregation, what an amazing gift. I'm so thankful. I've already commented to them and told them how thankful I am. And I'm sure the family is too.
If it's okay, Jason, let's take a quick break. And when we come back, I want to lay out how people can support this effort through the GoFundMe, how they can help however they can to the Fultondale community right now, because I know that there are places set up in Fulton, in Center Point at the City Hall. I know that in Gardendale at the Community Center, people can donate as well. There are other opportunities, but I want to make sure that everybody has the information they need to be able to support this effort during this time, okay?
Yes, sir.
Folks, we're talking to Jason Vogt. He's a teacher at Fultondale Middle and High School. He's a geometry teacher, math teacher there in Fultondale. We appreciate the fact that he's on the program with us right now. And even more importantly so, I appreciate the fact that he's organized this fundraiser for Elliott's family. This is a time of their grief, heartbreak, all the things that you can experience when it comes to sad emotions they're feeling right now. But at the same time, there's this bright spot. And it's encouragement from the community, not the money necessarily, but seeing people who support them and care about them. And I want you to stick with us as we continue to share about this effort. And I want you to think about where you can fit into this fundraising effort, how you can help. You're listening to The Mark White Show, and I'm your host, Mark White.
A little wink, a pat on the back, a big old hug, a little laugh. We can make a difference. All we have to do is try. Yeah, every day's a chance to change somebody else's life. Let's all do something good today.
The best way to buy, sell, and experience land is with Jonathan Berryhill. For your farm, ranch, recreational, hunting, timber, and acreage needs, contact National Land Realty Professional Jonathan Berryhill at 256-874-7354 or email at jberryhill@nationalland.com. Be sure to follow Jonathan Berryhill with National Land Realty on Facebook. This is your land.
Thompson Roofing and Construction is a locally owned family business serving the North Alabama and Southern Tennessee area. They are a Better Business Bureau A-plus member since 2011 and a GAF Master Elite Contractor. Give them a call at 256-952-3309 or check them out on the web at 256roofing.com. They offer free inspections.
Thompson Roofing and Construction.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the legal services performed by other lawyers.
Losing a loved one is hard, but losing a loved one and not having an estate plan is even harder. Attorney Harlan Mitchell witnessed what not having an estate plan can do to families and decided to use his experience to do something about it. I encourage you to go to BamaEstatePlanning.com or give Harlan Mitchell a call at 256-216-9884. Again, that website is BamaEstatePlanning.com. Let Harlan Mitchell help you with estate planning. Do it for those you love and do it today.
Boutique Air in Muscle Shoals, Alabama offers direct flights to Atlanta, Nashville, and Pensacola. Boutique Air service runs twice daily, 7 days a week, with fares starting at $59. Follow Boutique Air Muscle Shoals on Facebook at Boutique Air MSL and book your flight through BoutiqueAir.com. Boutique Air.
Where you can fly private for the cost of commercial.
Do you have knee, shoulder, elbow, and other joint pain? Would you like immediate relief without surgery? Let me introduce you to Dr. Michael Farah, who's been serving patients around the world since 1986. At Freedom Medical Center and Trinity Medical Care, you can get platelet-rich plasma injections and other treatments. Dr. Farah is your choice for cosmetic and regenerative medicine. Schedule your consult today at Trinity Medical Care by calling 256-489-3192. That's Trinity Medical Care, located at 8010 South Parkway in Huntsville. Walk-ins are welcome.
This is Emma Grace Faradelli, and you're listening to The Mark White Show. I am a 12-year-old self-esteem rising ambassador for the Hans Family Foundation. I really hope you get to check them out. And don't ever forget, confidence is a superpower.
Is up early so he can get away.
white kid on second base. Wants dad to watch him play. Daddy knows he's waiting.
Welcome back to the Mark White Show. We're talking to Jason Vogt. He's a teacher at Fultondale Middle and High School. As many of you know, January 25th, Monday, just a few days ago, we had a tornado go through Fultondale. It also hit Centerpoint. It also hit Tarrant. It hit North Jefferson County area. We saw buildings demolished. A life was lost in this. And as we said, a life can't be replaced. Elliott Arizaga-Hernandez, his family's grieving right now. His teacher wanted to organize a fundraiser to help this family, and that's exactly what he's done. And I want Jason to be able to share how you can help. Welcome back to the Mark White Show, Jason Vogt.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Yeah, so we created a GoFundMe page. You can find it by searching Elliott Arizaga-Hernandez and GoFundMe. You can also find it on NBC's News and AL.com. They have links there as well in both of those locations. Great way for you to donate to the cause.
And as you said, you want it to go beyond the state of Alabama, and it is reaching. If it's hitting NBC News and AL.com, it is reaching outside of the state of Alabama. And we're going to have many people who want to help this family. I do want to make sure that people know the spelling when they are searching. Elliott, E-L-L-I-O-T-T, Arizaga, A-R-I-Z-A-G-A, hyphen, Hernandez, H-E-R-N-A-N-D-E-Z. And you can find that by searching on the GoFundMe, Elliott Arizaga-Hernandez Relief and Memorial Fund. And as you said, I know that the family appreciates the support. And I know that you appreciate witnessing. You get the messages from people, a lot of anonymous people who donate. You will actually see these special messages that others will not see, and you'll see the heart of these people.
Yeah, you're 100% right. I told my wife last night that I was just overwhelmed. I didn't know what to expect. And I'm just taken aback that this little idea could have such a huge impact for this family. I'm just super thankful.
How old was Elliott?
Elliott was a 14-year-old freshman. He had the future in front of him. He wanted to be something special. I want to do anything that I can do to help, and I'm thankful for this opportunity, Mr. White.
Well, I want the family to know right now, Jason, that this show is dedicated to Elliott. It's dedicated to his memory. He's going to be missed, I know, by many people. At 14 years old and thinking about his life ahead of him, this family's grief, if we can step into their shoes and think about what they're going through right now and the pain that they're feeling, this is the way we connect as people. This is the way we do make a difference in our communities, is by coming together when someone has tragedy strike like this.
I completely agree.
Well, Jason, you keep up the good work. I know that running a GoFundMe is a challenge, but I know that you're up for it. It sounds like you're up for it, and I appreciate the fact that you organized this fundraiser, and you've got my support. I'm in your corner. Whatever you need,
thank you, sir.
I'm here, and I appreciate your work as a teacher. We appreciate those who are so dedicated to the profession that they care about their students in this way, and you never want to have to do this for anybody, but you're making it happen, my friend.
I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
We appreciate Jason Vogt joining us. He's a teacher at Fultondale Middle and High School. He was a teacher for Elliott Arizaga-Hernandez, who lost his life, a 14-year-old lost his life in the tornado January 25th on Monday night in Fultondale, Alabama. His family has our support, and I hope that his family has your support too, now that you know his story. I hope that you'll go to the GoFundMe, search Elliott Arizaga-Hernandez Relief and Memorial Fund, and find your opportunity to be a part of this family's life by helping them move forward on this journey that they have now taken part in. We can do this together. We can do this as a community. You know that the Mark White Show recognizes difference makers and shares their stories to encourage and inspire us all. As I said, this show is dedicated to Elliott Arizaga-Hernandez and his memory. I hope that you will support the Mark White Show by following the Mark White Show on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. You can follow the Mark White Show podcast at Apple iTunes, Spotify, Stitcher, Audio Boom, SoundCloud, Blueberry, and on YouTube. Share this show with your friends, your neighbors, and your family, and let them know about what this teacher is doing for his special student and his family. This is Mark White encouraging you to find your purpose by making a difference in someone's life today.
Dear hearts,
and gentle people who shout a friendly hi when they go passing by, who live and love in my hometown. Ah, these are my kind of people.
Hi, everybody. This is DJ Thomas. You know, raindrops may be falling on your head, but on Kyler's Corner, she's living life sunny side up. Nothing
seems to fit. You are my sunshine. Only.
This is Kyla Carter of Kyla's Corner. You can hear my segment every Saturday at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time and 11 a.m. Eastern Time on The Mark White Show. Remember to tune in every Saturday and always live life sunny side up.
Please don't take my sunshine away.
Hey everyone, I just wanted to pass along this really important message because it's important to me and everybody around me. Did you know that 22.6 million Americans have battled COVID-19? Now, a huge surge in COVID cases has risen up in the US, but if you have recovered from COVID-19, you may have powerful antibodies in your blood plasma. Like, what? That's absolutely insane. One COVID plasma donation can help save 4 COVID patients. So if you want to be a hero, which I know you do, just go to a donation bank for blood or give some of your plasma if you have recovered from COVID. Anything helps. Love you.
Is it time for a haircut? Go see my friends Philip Butler and B.H. Parker at Southwind Barbershop, located at 1637 Lee Street in Rogersville, Alabama. Give them a call at 256-247-5658. That's 256-247-5658.
If you like hickory smoked ribs that fall apart at the slightest pull, or barbecue shoulders that are so slow smoked each tender bite melts in your mouth, then you are going to love Baby Jack's Barbecue. Baby Jack's Barbecue in Bartlett and Arlington. Try the barbecue chicken, beef brisket sandwich, barbecue potato, it is huge, or the Baby Jack Trio, pork, turkey, or beef brisket sliders. You like wet ribs? They like dry ribs. Get one slab that has them both. Catering? Baby Jack's can feed a family or an army. Drive in, drive through, order online, or come in and set them in. Baby Jack's Barbecue in Bartlett at Highway 70 in Appling, or in Arlington at Highway 70, just a block west of 385.
Located in Tuscumbia, Alabama, the Alabama Music Hall of Fame honors Alabama's music achievers. You can even go into the recording studio and try out your talents as a singer. That's the Alabama Music Hall of Fame, located at 617 Highway 72 West in Tuscumbia, Alabama. Open Tuesday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Give them a call at 256-381-4417. Check them out on the web at alamhof.org.
Hello, my name is Christian Martinez. I'm a rising senior at Athens Bible School. My school is great because of the wonderful environment in which students can grow and flourish. We have great academics that include the university preparatory diploma and dual enrollment courses that lead to an associate's degree before high school graduation. All my teachers and the school's employees are Christians who are devoted to the welfare of students. We have an excellent student body, competitive sports program, and study the Bible first thing every day. It's a great place. Please consider joining us at ABS next year, or give that special child in your life the great opportunity I have.
Mr. Cecil Batchelor is the one that started this business as Dependable Service Center. And even though now it's Green's Dependable Hardware and we're a true value store, our tagline is still your Dependable Service Center. We've tried to keep that alive for all these years. Mr. Batchelor really started a good business. We're really excited to be carrying on a long-standing tradition. It's the oldest retail store in the city of Russellville. We're Green's Dependable Hardware, 15220A Highway 43 in Russellville, Alabama. We're right behind McDonald's or right across the street from the hospital. Number is 256-331-0123.
The Dependable Service Center.
Oh, won't you hear me, people, when I say, well, let's all do something good today.